Hello guys, today's video is a bit different. You see here a dog. Buddy, buddy, yeah. He walked all day, he was in the fields. Yeah, work for his family. Now he needs to rest. Buddy, no, yeah, he moved his tail, but don't give a damn. Okay, buddy, I'm working at the current time on the Endeavour. I'm making the masts, but I feel tired with the work, so I said to make something different. The idea came from one of my viewers, Jose Carlos Melo. I hope that I'm pronouncing that correctly. What we're going to do today is talk about electronics. This will be a perfect guide for everyone who wants to put LEDs on its models. We have here some of what I'm going to show you. We start from the power supply unit, which is very simple. And we will proceed of how to connect LED strips and all the stuff. In the process, I'm going to use a power supply unit that I have here. It's a DC power supply unit. It's regulated. I can get an output of from 2 up to 30 volt. And also going to need this multimeter so I can show you a lot about this stuff. But let me put the camera on a tripod and we will begin by making the drawing, the schematics for the power supply unit. So, let's begin. For those in doubt, let me tell you that I have 2 degrees in electronics. So, if anyone has any doubt or think that this can be done, this is what I'm drawing or will tell you is wrong, can tell me about it. For the reference, I'm going to use an input voltage of 12 volt AC. That's AC, not DC. That's the voltage that we get out of a transformer. The transformer, if I remember correctly, its symbol is like this. Here we have the input. This is input. We're talking about 110 or 220. Doesn't make any difference. This is AC out. We're talking about 12 volt. When I put a dot, it means that the wires are going to be connected. When I pass a wire from over another without a dot, it means that they do not touch, they're not connected. Now, the AC voltage that comes out here, is it has this form. We don't want that, we cannot work with that, so we have to make this a DC voltage. For that comes a bridge circuit. It comes in various shapes, various sizes. The bigger doesn't mean the better, it's for more amperes. Here we have volts and amperes. Everything we're going to do later on the LEDs are based on Ohm's law, which is voltage equals current multiply by resistor. This is Ohm's law. If you paid attention in mathematics in high school, you know that this can be transformed like that. This is 1. So if you use this reference, you know how to do everything. That amperes are equal to etc. or resistors are equal to etc. This is how you do it. High school mathematics. Back to what we're doing here. We have, this is a bridge circuit. It can comes, like I said, in various shapes and sizes, but always, always has 4 feet. On the bridge circuit, you can, I don't know if it's visible over there in the camera, you always get some markings of which is the AC input and which is the ground, which is the positive output. On this one, the left foot is the positive output, the right foot is the negative output, and the two middle ones are the AC input. This bridge circuit has this symbol. This is the AC. This is ground. I did that the other way, ground, and this is the positive output. This will be connected to this. So we take the output from the transformer and we're connecting to the two AC feet of the bridge circuit. Immediately on the output, let me do that like this, we're going to need that. This is the ground. Like I said, these are not connected. I don't have a dot. Immediately here, we will have this. So, we have a DC, but not what we like. We need to have a steady output, and this is not a steady. So, to fix that, we're going to use a small capacitor. Each capacitor, it's this electrolytic capacitor. We don't need more than 2.2 microfarads. This, 2,200 microfarads. This is at 25 volts. The voltage is what the capacitor can handle. We're talking about 12 voltage output, so a 25 is the best. Voltage for the occasion. Do not use a capacitor at 16. You may have a ripple output that will tear the capacitor apart. It will burst and open up like a rose. So use a 25 volt capacitor. Doesn't mean that you cannot use bigger, more voltage, like 35, 63. No need to do that. It costs more and it's bigger. If you want to use an 1000 microfarad, you can do it. If you wish to use a more than 2200 microfarad, like 3300 or 4700, you can do it also. But there's no need, because these are used for purposes with large currents. We do not have large currents here. We have a small current and also 12 volts. So, this is the capacitor. It has 2 feet. 1 foot is smaller than the other. This foot is always has, this foot has always a marking. It's the ground, the negative one. So, here we connect the capacitor. It's like that. This is the negative one. So we connect the positive one over to the output of the bridge, and the negative one over to the output of the bridge, the negative part. So here, at this point, we'll get that. We have a DC current. That's what we need. But it's not a 12 volt DC current. It's not stabilized yet. For stabilization, we will use this. This is an IC circuit. It has 3 feet. It's a 78. It comes in various sizes also. This is the best one. It handles around
1.5 to 2 amperes. We do not need more. We're not going to have that more. So this is the appropriate case. It comes in smaller cases like this. This is the appropriate case. And it comes in bigger cases. And has 2 feet. The third is the case. We do not need this one. This is very small. Do not use it. It cannot handle the amperes that we're going to use here. This is the appropriate one. Like I said, this is a stabilizer. The stabilizers comes like LM from the company. Doesn't make a difference if here the number, the letters are different. What we need to know is the 7812. 12 is the voltage that is going to be stabilized, and 78, it means that it stabilizes positive. There are 7912. This means 12 is the voltage, 79 is the negative. We need positive stabilization. So we need the 7812. Of course, if you need to stabilize a 5 volt, you're going to buy a 7805. And goes on. In each and every one of these pieces, we have input, ground, output. This is steady. Doesn't get a different type unless you don't buy these parts. You buy something very different. So this is an IC circuit. I'm going to draw it like that. 7812. And we have 1 foot here, 1 foot here, 1 foot here. Like I said, this is input. Let's do that. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Input. Ground. Output. And here we have 12 volt DC. Very simple circuit, very easy to be done. All we have to do is connect everything with a small wire, like I seen in my videos to do, and you have 12 volt DC. If you have large amounts of amperes, if you have around 1.5 amperes to 2 amperes, it's better to have this on a metallic plate, so it will be able to cool itself. But for the LEDs we use in models, there's no need to do that at all. So, give me a moment. Let's talk about resistors. The resistors that we use comes in various sizes, in various colors, in various everything. Let me find one small one. I have here one. All right, let's talk about the resistors. First of all, let's explain the color over the resistors, because the coloring is how to measure how much ohms are each resistor. There is a pattern about the coloring. Numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So, 0 is black, 1 is brown, 2 is red, 3 is orange, 4 is yellow, 5 is green, 6 is blue, 7 is purple, 8 is gray. Gray comes with an A, I believe. Okay, maybe I misspelled that. And 9 is white. You will also find out that there are some colors over there. Gold and silver. This is 5%. This is 10%. I will explain what it is. Many of the resistors, have 4 colors. Here is one. Have 3, and you see one color apart. Others have 5. This one has 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And some has 6. Doesn't make any difference. Before continue, let me explain. The most common resistors are these, this type, this shape. This is 1/4 of the watt. This resistor is 1/4 of the watt. This small one is 1/8 of the watt, and this big one is 0.5 watts. These are the resistors that you're going to need in electronics when you place LEDs. There's no need to use bigger ones. This has to do with the current. If you remember Ohm's law, the voltage is I multiplies by resistor. So the current is a basic thing in resistor. So let me proceed. How to find out which resistor is which without having a multimeter? Give me a moment. All right, now here we have yellow as the first color. When you have 4 colors, the first 2 are numbers, the third one is zeros, multiply by zeros, and the last one is plus or minus the percentage from the actual value. So here what we have yellow, that's 4, purple, that's 7, that's 47, and brown. Brown means 1, 0, 1. So we have 470 plus or minus 5%. This is 470 ohms. This is the multimeter, plus or minus 5%, we're good. Let's see this one. This one has 5. When you have 5, the 3 first are numbers, the 4th is multiplying zeros, and the 5th is percentage sin, plus or minus like before. The color that it's near to the foot is the color that you need to read first. You can see here that this color is more near to the foot than the other. So here we have blue, 6. We have gray, 8. We have black, 0, 680. We have another black, that means 0 zeros. So we stick to 680. And on the end, we have brown, that means plus or minus 1%. So this one is a 680 ohms. Plus or minus 1%. We're very good. That's how you read the resistors. Now, one moment. Here we have some LEDs. The LEDs comes in various sizes and colors. I prefer the 3mm LEDs. They are perfect for what we're doing when you need to use LEDs directly, not LED strips. They come in clear, that's very bright always, and they come in colors like this green and red. These are not so bright as the clear ones, but these are very good when you need to have the color even with the LED turned off. All the LEDs of this size work between 3 and 4 volts. You will never apply voltage directly onto the LED because you will have two problems. One problem is you're going to have increased current, that means increased consumption. If you use a small battery of 3 voltage, the one that's flat, you will drain the battery in no time. And second is if you apply directly voltage without any circuit, it will probably burn the LED or reduce its life. So never direct voltage on the LED, only through resistors. Each LED has 2 feet, this type of LEDs, others have 3 or even more. The smallest one is the negative, the largest one is the positive. Also, let me see if I can focus here to show you something. You can see here that the LED inside has a bigger part and a very small one. If you have cut the feet so you don't know which one is which, the bigger part is always the negative and the smaller one is always the positive. Okay, easy to remember. The white LEDs turn on with 4 volt, if I remember correctly. The red, green, yellow turn on with around 3. Don't know the blue ones, I believe it's like the white ones. Don't care about blue ones, I'm not going to use any blue one in the SIPs. So what do I have here? I have yellow right here, I have bright white, I have orange, I have cool white over here. I have here cool white, I have red, I have everything. When you use a 12 volt DC power supply, the appropriate resistor is 680 ohms, 1/4 of the watt. You can use 0.5 watts or 1/8 of the watt, doesn't make any difference for one LED, that is. You can do every calculation through Ohm's law. Like I said before, voltage equals current and multiplies by a resistor. You have voltage, you have the resistor, you can understand what the the amperes are. It's very easy. For 12 volt, again, you can use 680. If you wish, so 12 volt DC, the appropriate resistor is 680 ohms. You can use 560, 470. You can use also 330, but this is risky. You can burn the LED. With this 560, you will get more brightness. More bright. You can understand less voltage on the resistor, more voltage to the LED, so you get a more bright LED. 330, maybe you will burn the lead. Don't go any lower. That's for a single lead. When you use leads, you always connect them parallel, never in series, always parallel. That's the rule. The leads are like that. This is the negative and this is the positive. So when you have leads, always connect them in parallel. Not in series. Series means like that. No. Wrong. This is how do you connect the lead. So the voltage remains always 12. And the only thing that changes is the current. So for that you will need just a bigger watt resistor. So, I believe we did a lot in theory. Let's try and play with them a little and use some LED strips also. Before playing, let's talk about the LED strips. Here we have a LED strip. The LED strips are coming normally in 5 meters length, 5 meters in foot, in feet, are around 15 feet, I believe, or something, around 15 feet. Each LED strip has markings where you can cut them. You can see here, I can cut the LED. This LED strips has 3 LEDs on the cut. I have another one that has more. Let me find it. Here I have a LED strip. You can see the cut is here, also here, also three. This one, my mistake. It has 3 LEDs between the cuts, but you can see that the cut, it's very close in the cut of the first one, with that I have 3 LEDs. On the other one, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 LEDs. You can understand that this is very bright and of course more expensive. The LED strips are working usually with 12 volts DC, that is. It also says on plus 12 volt. You have the ground, that's the minus, and also the positive, that's 12 volt. When you apply 12 volt to the LED strip, the LED strip will give you a normal brightness that it's required for the 5 meters length. If you cut this piece and you use only a part of it, like a small this part, like I did in the Titanic, or this part, it will also light up with 12 volts, but it will be brighter, because first you had many meters, many feet, and now you have just a foot or some centimeters. To reduce its brightness, you're going to need some resistors. The resistors are coming in different and various numbers, like I said before. You have to have in mind that smaller the resistor, it's better to have bigger watts. So when you use resistors like this one, that it's 47 ohms, this is half a watt. It's better to use half a watt than 1/4 of the watt. Like this one, this is 82 ohms, It's better to use half a watt. This is half a watt. This is a quarter to the watt. You can always use Ohm's law to calculate the resistor that you're going to need, but there's an easier way. Have a bunch of them. They come in specific resistors in specific ohms below 100 ohms. So let me write down what you can buy. 100. After that, it's 82. After that, it's around 70. I don't remember if it has anything. It's 68, 56, 47, 33, 22. Beneath the 22, you have some values. You can find 10. You're not going to need the 10. You're not going to need the 22. You're going to need not even a 33. You're going to need this and this. Also, what I forgot to tell you is that when you put one resistor next to another, the resistor sign is this one. If you connect one resistor next to the other one, you get an arithmetic calculation of the total resistor. That if this one is 100 and this one is 47, the total is 147. Do not connect them in parallel. Do not. The total resistor is half, it's the total, let me do that here, it's smaller than the minimum one. So if this one is 100 and this one is 47, the total will be smaller than 47. So no parallel connections for the resistors. You can do them in series. There's not a problem over there. So if you need some resistor to make the brightness be less, you can do a connection with a more two or three resistors until you get the brightness that you need. So what I was saying is that when you use a LED strip, you have to have some resistors to reduce the brightness, because if you cut off the piece, this will light up with 12 volt, but it's going to light up a lot. Now, I believe it's time to play. Give me a moment. Now, over here I have 12 volts. Let's see if I can connect that. Doesn't make any difference if I connect this over there or over here. I have 12 volts. It lights up. Let's put a 47 resistor to see what happens. It lights up, but with less brightness. Let me see how to make you able to see that. I need this one over here and this one. So from here I have 12 volts. Over here I have less. You can see the brightness changing just with a 47 ohms resistance. Let's put an 82, double the amount. We have 12, doesn't light up, just lighting up, just. This is with 82. So the easiest way to achieve what you want is to play with the resistors, or you can use Ohm's law. That's with the LED strips, especially if you cut them short. Now let's play with LEDs. I'm not going to put the LED directly over to 12 volt, of course. This one is yellow, I believe. Here is the minus. I need this one. This is 680 ohms. Ah, this one is green. And I got it out of orange. Perfect. Found that it was wrong. Out of the orange pack. Yeah, love that. Out of the yellow pack. Imagine to put the yellow ones and you have green. Yeah, this one's yellow. 680 ohms. This must be purple. 680 ohms. Let's make that brighter. I will ditch the 680 and I'm going to use this 470. A lot less. So we have here the purple. And here we have the yellow. Let's go even lower. I need a 330. That's, like I said, risky. But we will do it. Let me find one. 330, got it. Maybe I will burn the LED, but okay, no problem with that. Very bright and dangerous to burn it. Also very bright. Easy way. Easy to do everything. So, I believe I helped you a lot with the schematics, with how to use, how to connect. Remember that all the LEDs must be connected parallel, only in parallel, not in series like I did here, only parallel. This is how you can read a resistor, or of course if you have a multimeter, it's the easiest way. You can have some various resistors. Let me write down the numbers. This, if you add a zero, you can get the resistors from above 100. So we have 122. No, wrong. 222 after the 100, 330, 470, 560, 680. You do not need bigger than this one. This is the top you can get. No need to do a bigger one for the voltage and the currents that were working at the moment. If we were talking about different types of, I don't remember the coloring now, different types of LEDs, let's say using light bulbs, then we'll have different currents, so we will need definitely different resistors. So this one is yellow. Okay, the yellow goes over here. The other one was orange. So guys, I believe that you find this video very helpful. It was different from the others, but it has a lot of knowledge inside, so you can connect everything on your own. And I suggest that before connecting everything, play a little with buy some resistors. They are very cheap, very cheap. I believe this package must be less than a euro. Less. They are very cheap. Remember to buy some of 1/4. It's the basic of 0.5 watts. Maybe you will need them. Buy some capacitors, some bridge circuits, some regulators, and you will up for playing and making your own power supply units and LED circuits. So thank you very much for watching, guys. I will see you soon with one of the other videos.